my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig. School project.
Peppa and her friends are at playgroup.
Children, who can tell me what this is?
It's a castle.
That's right, Danny. And for your school project, I want you to go home and make a castle.
Wow!
You can make your castles from any old bits and bobs you find at home. Cardboard, plastic bottles, egg boxes.
Can we use glitter?
Oh, please, not too much glitter. It gets everywhere.
Can I make the castle big?
Make it as big as you like. The only limit is your imagination.
It is breakfast time at Peppa's house.
Mummy, Daddy, I've got some very good news.
What's that, Peppa?
I am doing a new school project.
School project?
Oh, what is it, Peppa?
I need to make a castle.
Okay, why don't you use this empty cereal box? Stick these yogurt pots on the sides, and what have you got?
A box with pots on it. No, Daddy, it has to be good.
Peppa, what exactly did Madame Gazelle tell you to do?
She told us to use our imagination. And a fantastic castle is what I am imagining. And my castle has to be big enough for me to live in.
I see.
Right.
It is breakfast at Susie Sheep's house.
Madame Gazelle told you to make a real fairy palace?
Yes, with all the little fiddly bits.
Hello, sorry, but I can't come into work today. It's a school project. Yes, yes. Thanks, but I should be able to manage.
This is what my castle looks like, but much, much bigger.
If it needs to be big, we should use concrete.
No, Daddy Pig. We just need to find a big enough cardboard box.
Have we got a big box?
No.
Delivery for Daddy Pig.
I don't remember ordering anything this large. It's just a new light bulb. Why do they use so much packaging for these things?
Shall I take the box away for you?
Oh, yes. Thank you.
No, Daddy. We need that box. Look what I've got.
Great. That's your castle almost done.
Hooray!
It's not almost done. We have to stick things on, paint it, add the glitter.
Glitter? Hello?
Hello. Can I speak to Peppa, please?
Peppa, it's Susie Sheep.
Hello, Susie. How's your school project going?
I'm doing very well. More pointy, Mummy, and it needs to be taller. How is your castle going?
It's quite hard work, but my Mummy and Daddy are helping a little tiny bit.
What do you think of this tower, Peppa?
Very good, but it still looks a bit cardboardy.
Maybe I can paint it.
I need to get on with my work now, Susie. See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye, Peppa.
What do you think, Peppa?
Wow, that looks just like a castle.
Oh, we got there in the end.
It just needs one more thing. Glitter!
Ooh, glitter would stop the castle looking real.
And anyway, we've, completely run out of glitter.
Peppa and her friends have brought their castles back to playgroup.
Wow, a fairy palace. That must have been a bit tricky for you to make, Susie.
No, it was easy.
My castle is made out of a cardboard box.
It is a very fine castle. Thank you, Madame Gazelle. Pedro, did you not make a castle?
I did, but it's too big to bring into school.
We built it out of stone blocks.
Isn't it wonderful what the children can make using just their imaginations?
And my castle really is big enough for me to live in.
Peppa loves school projects. Everyone loves school projects.
Brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig.
Peppa and George's garden.
Daddy Pig is sitting in his favourite sunny spot.
Ah, what a perfect day for doing nothing.
Daddy Pig loves doing nothing.
How could this be better? I know, a cup of tea.
Grandpa Pig has come to see Pepper and George.
Grandpa Pig! Papa Pig!
Hello, Pepper and George. You're going to have your very own flower garden.
Ooh, a garden for George and me.
I've got a packet of flower seeds for each of you. Now, we need a nice sunny spot to plant your seeds. Here we are.
Grandpa Pig is digging Pepper and George's garden.
Oh!
Ah, tea for the workers. Thank you, Daddy Pig.
What's going on?
We're making a flower garden.
Do we need a flower garden?
Yes!
But that's where I sit in my chair.
There are more important things than chairs, Daddy Pig.
But I always read my newspaper here.
There are more important things than newspapers, Daddy Pig.
Yes, like flowers.
Look, Daddy.
Peppa has lots of flower seeds. George only has one flower seed.
Oh.
But it is quite a big seed.
Could you fetch us some water, Daddy Pig?
Okay.
Seeds need water to grow. They get very thirsty.
Some little birds have come to watch.
Don't let the birds eat the seeds, Peppa.
Shoo, shoo, fly away, birdies.
Here's the water.
Daddy scared the birds away.
Oh, Daddy Pig looks like a scarecrow.
Peppa, George, bath time.
Oh, but what if the birdies come back?
Don't worry, Peppa. I'll make sure the birds don't eat the seeds.
Thank you, Daddy.
Good luck, Daddy Pig. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Ah, this is nice.
Daddy, you have to be the scarecrow.
What? Oh, shoo, shoo, naughty birds.
Now, stay there until the birdies go to bed.
Ho, ho, okay, Peppa.
All the birdies have gone to bed. Daddy Pig can go inside now. It is morning.
George, let's look at our flower garden. Ooh, baby plants.
Morning. Ah, your plants have started to grow. Soon they'll have flowers on them.
A little snail has come to take a look.
Oh, dear. Snails like eating plants.
Grandpa Pig, can you take Barbara to your garden?
Okay. I'll take care of Barbara.
It is 1 week later.
Peppa! George! Come and look!
My flowers! They're so pretty!
And look at George's plant.
It's a beanstalk. And it goes all the way up to a giant's castle.
Oh, no, Peppa. But it does go quite high.
George's flower is taller than our house.
Oh, George has grown a sunflower. Well done, George.
I love our flower garden.
Now let's make you a vegetable garden.
But that's where I sit in my chair.
There are more important things than chairs, Daddy Pig.
Like tomatoes, carrots and potatoes.
I do like a nice potato.
Daddy Pig loves potatoes. Everyone loves potatoes.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig.
Holiday in the sun.
It is the first morning of Peppa and her family's holiday in Italy.
Ah, holiday.
Daddy Pig is up bright and early.
I'll just go for a little walk.
Good morning, Mr. Pig. I see you have found the swimming pool.
This is Signor Goat. It is his job to look after the holiday house.
Daddy fell in the water.
It's not funny.
It is quite funny, Daddy.
Ho, ho. I suppose it is a bit funny.
This is my daughter.
Hello, I'm Gabriella Goat.
I'm Peppa Pig.
Tell us if you need anything at all.
We'd like to do some sightseeing.
The village is very pretty. I will show you.
Okay, I'll just change out of these wet clothes. I don't look like a tourist, do I?
You look perfect.
Is everybody ready?
Yes, Daddy Pig!
Then let's go!
This is Gabriella's village.
Here is the shop of my auntie.
Can I send a postcard?
Who is it for?
A goldfish.
A goldfish? Maybe a postcard of the sea.
Yes, Goldie the fish likes water.
Bongo drums, carpets, garden gnomes. Who buys all this rubbish?
Tourists.
Oh, hello.
Buongiorno.
Mummy Pig is buying lots of things to take home.
Mummy Pig, we haven't got room for all this in our suitcase.
Don't worry, Daddy Pig. They sell suitcases too.
This is the village cafe.
Ciao, Gabriella.
My uncle makes very good pizza.
You eat pizza in Italy?
Pizza is Italian food.
Oh, goody. I like pizza.
A little bit of tomato, a little bit of cheese, into the oven and...
Into my tummy.
Maybe we let them cook first, no?
Okay.
Peppa, let's write the postcard to your goldfish.
Yes, I miss her very much.
To Goldie, wish you were here.
Loving kisses, Peppa.
You can post the card here.
Goodbye, postcard. Fly home quickly.
Pizza, pizza, pizza.
Mmm, yummy.
Peppa loves pizza. Everybody loves pizza.
Did you like that, Teddy?
Yes, it was delicious.
Magnifico, Uncle Goat. There will always be a special place for your pizza in my tummy.
Thank you.
Ciao.
Goodbye.
Oh, dear. Peppa has left Teddy behind at the cafe.
What a lovely, relaxing holiday we're having. Oh, dear, it's the police.
Leave the talking to me. Hello, officer. I don't know what I did, but I won't do it again.
Mr. Pig, you're Teddy.
Teddy!
Thank you.
Just doing my job, signora.
Peppa and her family have arrived back at their holiday house.
Time for bed.
Can we ring Goldie the fish, Mummy?
Okay.
Granny and Grandpa Pig are looking after Goldie the fish while Peppa is on holiday.
I do hope we're feeding Goldie enough. Hello?
Hello, Grandpa. Is Goldie all right?
Goldie is fine.
I sent her a postcard today. Has it arrived?
Oh, not yet, but I'm sure it will get here soon.
Night, night, Grandpa.
Night, night, Peppa.
Peppa and George are fast asleep in their holiday house.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig. The police.
Peppa and her friends have brought their bikes to playgroup.
Children, today we have very important visitors. The police are coming to our playgroup.
Ooh.
The police drive cars with flashing lights.
Nina, Nina,
no,
Nina.
It's D-door, D-door,
no,
D-door.
Police cars go woo woo woo.
Nina, Nina, Nina,
yes,
D-door.
Yes, if I might explain, what I was about to say was...
Police! The police!
Here are the police.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
That is how the police say hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
I'm Police Officer Squirrel.
And I'm Police Officer Panda.
We're going to teach you how to ride your bicycle safely.
Ooh. Right, let's see you all riding your bikes.
Look where you're going!
Always keep your ears and eyes open. And stop!
Well done, children!
Now, suppose you're riding your bike along and someone steps out in front of you.
What do you do?
I would ring my bell.
Very good. Ringing your bell lets others know you are there.
Can you all show me how good you are at ringing bells?
I don't have a bell. I have a horn.
A horn is just as good as a bell. Could you give your horn a tiny little toot so that we can all...
Yes, that should be sufficient to alert the public of your approach.
Now for the last bit of the lesson.
Where's he going?
Police Officer Panda is driving to the bottom of the hill.
Calling Police Officer Squirrel. Over.
Can you read me? Over.
Read you loud and clear. Over.
The police have special phones to talk to each other.
I'm in position. Over.
Now, when I blow my whistle, I want you all to cycle down the hill and use your brakes to not bump into Police Officer Panda.
Okay.
They're on their way. Over.
I see them coming. Over. Very good braking, everyone.
Are you ready for Madam Gazelle? Over.
Send her down. Over.
I
don't think I need to do this. I am the teacher, and I wasn't supposed to be talking.
Off you go!
Ears and eyes open!
Ears and eyes open! Yes! Woohoo! This is fun!
Ring your bell!
Oh, yes! Ring bell!
Brakes!
Oh, yes! Brakes!
Well done! And that's how to ride your bicycles safely.
Children, thank the police for taking time off from their important work to talk to us today.
Thank you!
You're very welcome.
When I grow up, I want to be a policeman.
And what is it about being a policeman that you like?
I like blowing whistles.
Very good. But of course, there's more to being a police officer than blowing whistles.
Oh, yes. We're always very busy.
We do lots of very important things, like...
The police solve mysteries and drive cars with flashing lights. Nina, Nina, woo!
Spot on, Freddy. Right, we really must be on our way. And remember, always keep your ears and eyes open. Oh, who put that tree there?
Yes, it's not a safe place to put a tree. I'll make a note. Dangerous tree on public highway.
Ho-ho. You see, children, a police officer's work is never done. Bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Peppa loves the police. Everyone loves the police.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig. The Flying Vet.
Peppa has brought Goldie the fish to the vet's for a checkup.
You've got a healthy, happy fish. She's lovely.
Thank you, Dr. Hamster.
Hello.
Hello, Dr. Hamster. This is Mr. Elephant.
Mr. Elephant and his family are out for a walk in the mountains.
We found a sick lizard.
It's a gecko.
Edmund knows all about lizards. He is a clever clogs.
I'll be straight there.
Ooh, can we come too?
Of course. Let's go.
Are we going?
mountains.
No, the mountains are too far away. We'll go in my aeroplane.
Ooh!
Airplane! No!
George loves aeroplanes.
All aboard! Up, up and away!
I didn't know you had an aeroplane, Dr. Hamster.
Oh, yes. I'm the flying vet.
Thank goodness. The vet's here.
Stand aside. Vet coming through. Where is the sick lizard?
Here it is.
Oh, poor little Pickle.
What is wrong with the lizard?
It seems to be upside down. I just flip it over. There.
Dr. Hamster has made the lizard better.
Hooray!
Oh, another emergency. Hello?
Hello. Grandpa Pig here.
Grandpa Pig is out sailing his boat.
It's Polly. She's a sick parrot.
Sick parrot. I'll be right there.
Look, Polly, it's the flying vet.
Where are we going to land?
This is a seaplane, Peppa. We can land on the water.
Wow!
Hello, Peppa. George.
Hello, Grandpa. We've come to make Polly better.
How long has Polly been sick?
Since we came out on our boat trip.
Uh-huh. I know what's wrong with Polly. She's seasick.
Oh!
Get Polly to dry land. The sooner the better.
There's an island.
There we go. Better, Polly?
Better, Polly?
Hooray!
Polly is not a sick parrot anymore.
Oh, another emergency. Hello?
Hello? Daddy Pig here.
Daddy Pig is in his office.
There are some ducklings stuck on our roof.
I'll be right there.
Thank goodness you're here.
Stand aside. Dr. Hamster here.
Mrs. Duck laid her eggs on our roof.
And now the ducklings have hatched.
Who can make a quacking noise?
Me! I'm very good at quacking.
Peppa, start quacking and the ducklings will follow you.
Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack.
Lead them to the duck pond, please, Peppa.
OK, I'm Mummy Duck. Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack.
The ducklings are back with their mummy and daddy.
All because of me.
Hello?
Is it another emergency?
Yes, it's Mr. Hamster. I'm late for my tea. Bye.
Bye-bye, Dr. Hamster.
Thank you.
No problem.
It's all in a day's work for the flying vet.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig. The end of the holiday.
It is the last morning of Peppa's holiday in Italy.
I'm just going for one last walk. What?
Going for one last swim, Mr. Pig?
Yes. One last swim before I go home.
I want to stay on holiday forever.
Holidays are nice, but they don't last forever, Peppa.
Think of all your friends waiting for you back home.
Yes, I miss my friends. And I miss Goldie the fish. Can I telephone Goldie?
OK, Peppa.
Granny and Grandpa Pig are looking after Goldie the fish while Peppa is on holiday.
Hello?
Hello, Granny. How's Goldie?
She's eating well.
I sent Goldie a postcard. Does she like it?
The postcard?
postcard hasn't arrived yet, Peppa, but I'm sure it will be here soon.
Oh, we're coming home today.
See you later.
See you later.
Susie Sheep has come to play with Peppa.
Hello, Susie.
Hello, Granny Pig. Is Peppa back from holiday?
Not yet, Susie, but she's coming back today.
Oh.
Susie is missing Peppa.
This suitcase is heavy. Are you sure we need all this stuff, Mummy Pig?
These are important souvenirs from our holiday.
Okay. Is everybody ready?
Yes, Daddy Pig.
Then let's go home.
Bye-bye.
Ciao.
Oh, look.
Oh, dear. Peppa has forgotten Teddy.
What a lovely holiday.
Yes, I have never felt so relaxed.
Ah, hello, officer. Whatever I was doing, I won't do it again.
Mr. Pig, here is your Teddy. Please, take better care of him.
Teddy! We're going home today.
Susie Sheep cannot wait for Peppa to get back home.
Hello, Susie.
Is Peppa home yet?
No, Susie, but she's flying home now.
Flying high in the sky, flying high and high and high.
I hope it's sunny when we get home.
Peppa's family have arrived home.
Granny Pig, Grandpa Pig, Goldie! What has Grandpa done to you?
She has filled out a bit, hasn't she?
Naughty Grandpa, you fed her too much.
She was always hungry.
We've brought you some presents from Italy.
Look, Grandpa, a beautiful garden gnome.
Oh, you really shouldn't have.
Granny, has my postcard arrived?
No, Peppa, not yet.
Oh, that's my postcard.
Hello.
Oh, it's only Susie.
I've really missed you, Peppa.
I've missed you too, Susie.
Peppa and Susie are best friends. Here is Mr. Zebra, the postman.
A postcard all the way from Italy.
Ho, ho! We got here quicker than the postcard.
Look, Goldie. I sent you this postcard from our holiday.
Did you have a nice time on holiday, Peppa?
Yes. Did you have a nice time?
It rained every day.
Oh, goody. That means there'll be muddy puddles.
Peppa and Susie love jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
Holidays are nice, but coming home to muddy puddles is even better.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig.
Mummy Pig's book.
Mummy Pig is working on the computer.
Mummy, can we play Happy Mrs. Chicken on the computer?
Not at the moment, Peppa. I need to finish the important book I'm writing.
Daddy Pig is in the kitchen making lunch.
Daddy, when can we play Happy Mrs. Chicken?
When Mummy has finished writing her book.
Oh, that's it. After lots and lots of hard work, I've finally finished writing my book.
Well done, Mummy Pig.
Now we can play Happy Mrs. Chicken. Hooray!
You did save your work, didn't you?
Ah, no, I didn't press save.
40, 90, 10, 1,000,112. Well done, George. That's the highest score ever.
Duh, my work. Where's my work? Ah, there it is. Quick, save close. Send. Phew.
Is your work all right, Mummy?
Yes, Peppa. I've just sent it off to be made into a real storybook.
Ooh, a storybook.
Not just one book. Lots and lots of books. Going to bookshops everywhere.
Wow. Mummy, can you read us your story?
Yes, I'm going to read it to you and your friends at playgroup tomorrow.
Mummy Pig has arrived at the playgroup with lots of copies of her new book.
Thank you, Mummy Pig, for coming to read your new book to us today.
It's very exciting. These books are so new, I haven't even opened one yet.
Children, Mummy Pig has worked hard to write this book, so we must listen politely, even if it is not very good.
Thank you. It's about an onion.
Ooh!
Once upon a time, there was an onion called Funny Onion. 476-859-3... Oh.
The rest of the book is one big long number.
I don't understand.
This is not what I wrote. What is 476-859...
It's George's Happy Mrs. Chicken High Score.
Wow, that is a high score. But where's my Funny Onion story? It's gone. I'm sorry, children, but I can't read Funny Onion to you today.
Oh.
Can you remember the story, Mummy Pig?
Yes. Then just tell us the rest. All right.
Once upon a time, there was an onion called Funny Onion. All he wanted was to make people laugh, but he made people cry instead because he was an onion.
What a beautiful, sad ending.
No, wait, Madam Gazelle, it's not finished.
Oh, I see. Carry on.
Funny Onion said, I will search the world to learn how to be funny. He met a tomato. The tomato said, wear a funny hat. But people still cried. He met a banana who said, wear some funny shoes. But people still cried. Funny Onion was ready to give up when a pineapple whispered in his ear. What do you think the pineapple said?
Wear a funny red nose.
Wear a purple wig.
Very good. But what the pineapple really said was, do something funny. Funny Onion did something funny, and everyone laughed. They laughed and laughed and laughed. The end.
Marvellous. I think it speaks to all of us.
The parents have come to collect the children.
I've just been to the bookshop, Mummy Pig. It's full of your books. What did you mean by 453967?
Well, actually...
It's probably post-narrative. Very modern.
Well done, Mummy Pig.
Thank you.
The parents love Mummy Pig's book. The children love Mummy Pig's book. Everyone loves Mummy Pig's book.
Brother George,
this is Mummy Pig,
and this is Daddy Pig.
Peppa Pig.
The Flying Vet.
Peppa has brought Goldie the fish to the vet's for a checkup.
You've got a healthy, happy fish. She's lovely.
Thank you, Dr. Hamster.
Hello.
Hello, Dr. Hamster. This is Mr. Elephant.
Mr. Elephant and his family are out for a walk in the mountains.
We found a sick lizard.
It's a gecko.
Edmund knows all about lizards. He is a clever clogs.
I'll be straight there.
Ooh, can we come too?
Of course. Let's go.
Are we going in an ambulance?
No, the mountains are too far away. We'll go in my aeroplane.
Ooh!
Airplane! Meow!
George loves aeroplanes.
All aboard! Up, up and away!
I didn't know you had an aeroplane, Dr. Hamster.
Oh, yes. I'm the flying vet.
Thank goodness. The vet's here.
Stand aside, vet coming through. Where is the sick lizard?
Here it is.
Oh, people.
What is wrong with the lizard?
It seems to be upside down. I just flip it over. There.
Dr. Hamster has made the lizard better.
Hooray!
Oh, another emergency. Hello?
Hello. Grandpa Pig here.
Grandpa Pig is out sailing his boat.
It's Polly. She's a sick parrot.
Sick parrot. I'll be right there.
Look, Polly. It's the flying vet.
Where are we going to land?
This is a seaplane, Peppa. We can land on the water.
Hello, Peppa, George.
Hello, Grandpa. We've come to make Polly better.
How long has Polly been sick?
Since we came out on our boat trip.
Uh-huh. I know what's wrong with Polly. She's seasick.
Oh.
Get Polly to dry land. The sooner the better.
There's an island.
There we go. Better, Polly?
Better, Polly?
Hooray!
Polly is not a sick parrot anymore.
Oh, another emergency. Hello?
Hello? Daddy Pig here.
Daddy Pig is in his office.
There are some ducklings stuck on our roof.
I'll be right there.
Thank goodness you're here.
Stand aside. Dr. Hamster here.
Mrs. Duck laid her eggs on our roof.
And now the ducklings have hatched.
Who can make a quacking noise?
Me! I'm very good at quacking.
Peppa, start quacking and the ducklings will follow you.
Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack.
Lead them to the duck pond, please, Peppa.
OK. I'm Mummy Duck. Quack, quack, quack. Quack, quack, quack.
The ducklings are back with their mummy and daddy.
All because of me.
Hello?
Is it another emergency?
Yes, it's Mr. Hamster. I'm late for my tea. Bye!
Bye-bye, Dr. Hamster.
Thank you!
No problem.
It's all in a day's work for the flying vet.
I'm Peppa Pig.
This is my little brother, George.
This is Mummy Pig.
And this is Daddy Pig.
Peppa Pig.
Mirrors.
Mummy Pig is fixing a big mirror onto the bathroom wall.
Lovely.
George thinks there is another little piggy in the bathroom.
It's a mirror, George. Mirrors are shiny. That's why you can see yourself.
George, what are you doing?
George is looking at himself in the big shiny mirror.
It is very shiny. Come on, George. Let's find some more shiny things. Daddy, we're looking for shiny things to see ourselves in.
Have a look in a spoon.
Ooh.
Peppa and George can see their faces in the shiny spoons.
Our faces look funny.
Now, turn the spoon around.
I'm upside down.
And turn it round again.
Now I'm the right way up. How does that work, Daddy?
It's simple, Peppa. Concave surfaces reflect light waves inversely to their origin. And...
Is it magic?
Yes, it's magic.
Susie Sheep has come to play with Peppa.
Hello, Peppa and George.
Hello, Susie. Look at that.
It's a spoon.
It's a shiny spoon. Look, I can make you go upside down.
Ooh! How does that work?
It's magic. My daddy says so.
Ah, let's find some more magic shiny things in the garden.
George has found a muddy puddle.
Ooh, it's shiny enough to see our faces.
I can see the sky. There's a cloud.
Here are Pedro Pony and Danny Dog.
Hello everyone.
Did you drop something in that puddle?
No, we're looking at the sky.
But the sky is in the sky.
Look at this spoon.
That's my face. It looks funny. Whoa! Now I'm upside down. How does that work?
It's a funny magic mirror spoon.
I know where there are some big funny mirrors.
Really?
Wobbly mirrors in a tent.
Where are these wobbly mirrors?
At the fair.
The parents have brought the children to a fair.
Roll up, roll up. See my amazing wobbly mirrors.
The tent is full of big wobbly mirrors.
Ooh, what's happened to my body?
You're a wobbly jelly.
Wobble, wobble, wobble. How does it do that, Daddy?
It's very simple. Illusions of optical differentials by convex and concave surfaces generate patterns...
So it's magic?
Yes, it's magic.
Look at me! I've gone all squishy!
I've got a long neck, like a giraffe.
This mirror looks normal to me.
Daddy! Where's your big tummy gone?
What tummy?
It is Mummy Rabbit with her baby twins, Rosie and Robbie.
Hello, sister. How are you today? Very good, sister. Mustn't chat for long, though. I've got customers inside the tent. Aren't the mirrors amazing, Daddy Pig?
Wow! I can see two of you.
What do you mean?
I can see you in the mirror... But there's no mirror. Is it magic?
Silly Daddy. It's Miss Rabbit and Mummy Rabbit.
Oh.
I suppose we do look a bit the same.
Well, we are sisters.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig.
Bimbo the zoo. Bimbo.
Peppa and her playgroup are visiting the zoo for the day.
Going to the zoo. Bing bong bing. Bong bing boom. We're all going to the zoo.
Children, are you ready to see all kinds of animals?
Yes, Madam Gazelle.
Today, we will be meeting wild animals.
Ooh!
But don't worry, the wild animals will be safely behind fences. A lion has escaped!
Hello, I'm Mr. Lion. Welcome to the zoo.
It is Mr. Lion, the zookeeper.
Hello, Mr. Lion.
You've picked a good time to visit. It's feeding time.
Ooh!
This way to the animals. Here are the tortoises.
Ooh!
We keep this gate shut so they don't run away.
They don't look like they could ever run.
No, they're moving very slowly.
Yes, that's why they live to be so old.
How long do they live?
Tortoises can live 100 years.
Wow!
Now, feeding time. Who knows what tortoises like to eat?
Tortoises like to eat vegetables.
That's right. That's why we feed them lettuce.
Mr. Lion is feeding the tortoises lettuce.
But of course, children, not all animals eat vegetables.
That's right, Mrs. Wildebeest.
My name is Madame Gazelle.
Sorry, gazelle, wildebeest. For some reason, I always get those two mixed up.
Mr. Lion, what animal will we
we see next?
I'll give you a clue. It lives in water.
Is it a whale or a shark?
Oh, wait and see. Look carefully into the water.
I can't see anything.
There's nothing in there.
Wait, I think I see something. Ah! Crocodile!
Hello, I'm Mrs. Crocodile. I'm the keeper in charge of the penguins.
Ah, penguins!
Adorable, aren't they? And now it's their feeding time. Penguins eat fish.
Ooh. Penguins are very good at catching. And waddling. And they like to swim.
If you look through the glass wall, you can see the penguins swimming underwater.
Wow!
They're really good at swimming.
Yes, that's why we have this fancy pool for them.
Very interesting. Thank you, Mrs. Crocodile and Mr. Lion.
It's our pleasure, Mrs. Wildebeest.
Gazelle.
Of course, yes. Gazelle.
What animal are we meeting next?
I can see it. It's very tall. It's a giraffe.
Yes, that's my dad. He's a keeper at the zoo.
Hello, I'm Mr. Giraffe.
Hello, Mr. Giraffe.
What sort of animal are you looking after?
See if you can guess.
Look up there. There's a net.
It must be a flying wild animal.
It must be hiding, watching us, waiting to pounce.
Ooh, butterflies.
Mr. Giraffe looks after the butterflies.
Is it the butterflies' feeding time?
Yes, and the butterflies get all the food they need from these flowers.
It is amazing they can live on just the food from flowers.
I wish I could get by just eating flowers.
Yes.
All this talk of eating has made me quite hungry.
Me too. Well, it's our feeding time now.
What's for lunch today, Mr. Lion?
Oh-ho! Lunch boxes for everyone. Sandwiches, fruit juice, and an apple.
Little picnics in boxes.
Tuck in, everyone.
Hooray!
Mr. Lion loves feeding time at the zoo. Everyone loves feeding time at the zoo.